Okay, I told you I would share with you exactly how to do it quickly, and I'm going to tell you right now. It starts with a greater commitment to understanding and connecting to your market, your prospect, your clients, and anyone else. There's an easy, instant way to do it and get a multi-billion dollar education overnight. Seriously, a multi-billion dollar education overnight with no cost or investment on your part. I'll explain it right now. Whatever the product or the service that you sell, go to Amazon.com or whatever the equivalent of that kind of a platform is in Japan, and also go to the communities and the discussion groups and look up, first of all, the top 25 books on the subject that your product or service addresses or is focused on. And also look up all the alternative categories. For example, if you were doing weight loss, you do weight loss, you do fitness, you do diabetes, you do all the different reasons people want weight loss, reducing high blood pressure. And you'd find the top 25 books in each of those categories, and you would look very carefully at the titles of those books and the subtitles. Why? Because books are sold mostly by the benefit and the promise that is made in the title, not by the content. If you study 25 of the top titles and the subtitles, the second title, you will get language patterns you can repeat right back to your prospect that will be the most powerful and the most compelling messages they could receive. Why do I say that? Because these are the books that are selling the best because they're title conveys a message. Now, that's the first thing. You want to go deeper, which you do. Now you go to each of those 25 books and you look at the consumer reviews. You look at what the actual readers of the book, if it's a book or if it's a discussion group, what the users had to say. And normally there are reviews that are very positive and very negative. Positive on Amazon here is a 5, negative is a 0. When people are passionate, passion can mean positive passion, I'm so excited, I'm so thrilled, I'm so happy. Or when they're negative, I'm so disappointed, I'm so angry, it wasn't what I wanted. Their subconscious takes over and they write and they communicate in language patterns that truly express what they feel in their heart and mind, if it's good or bad. They might say, for the first time, I learned how to manage my weight, build lean muscles, and not be hungry. Or they might be negative and say, it was just another rework of an old concept that I already knew. The point is, if you study, first of all, the titles, because the best-selling books are usually the ones whose name and title express the promise, the biggest promise people want. If you can get that language pattern into the way you communicate, your website, your selling approaches, your salespeople, your emails, you will connect at a deeper level. If you can then see what people love or hate about various products, you can use those very powerful language approaches to communicate, because the key to locking in trust and ethically programming people is to have them sense and feel that you understand them better than anybody else, that you appreciate them better than anybody else. And the best way to do it is to express in language what they're feeling in their heart. Now, there is another category to the same element. You must be committed to respect and appreciate the intelligence and the value of your market. You can't just see them as a transaction. One of my top mentors told me early in my career. Jay, you may or may not share exactly the viewpoints of your market, but you need to understand, you need to evaluate, you need to examine, you need to appreciate, you need to comprehend, you need to acknowledge to them, show them that you understand how they see life, because the more they feel like you are more connected than any of your competitors, that you care more, you do more, you understand them more, you will get the benefit. So that's the first part. There's one more element to this same question, and I don't want to take too long, but you have the ability to set the buyer's buying criteria. That means that when you first have contact, whether it's an ad they see, whether it's a website, whether it's a keyword, whether it's a blog, whether it's a brochure, whether it's your salesperson, rather than trying to sell the product, you can gain massive advantage and deep control by starting out saying, let's talk first about what you're trying to accomplish with this purchase, and let's talk about the buying criteria you should be looking at. And by that, what I mean to you in the audience is you set for the buyer the elements they should want. For example, if you're buying a piece of software, you should make sure that you talk to many other people that are using it and you find out the good and the bad. You should make sure that they have a system that covers you when anything goes down. You should make sure that you can get technical response 24/7. You should make sure, and you just walk through all the elements the buyer should want to see included in the product, the service, or the company he or she is buying from, and you make sure that those are, in fact, the elements that your company or your product or your service offers in ways the competition doesn't. Now, believe it or not, I could give you 50 more of these elements just in the beginning to establish, you know, a brand new relationship. But if you basically try to make the consumer, the prospect, better educated, better informed, and better knowledgeable, they will appreciate you more. So the last element in my first point is take the time to educate them. Give them the most well-balanced, the most authoritative but simple education you can on the differences between different products, services, the difference in performance, what they should want, what they should expect, why they should expect it, why your product or your service or your company performs better or performs longer or performs more consistently or whatever. And I can't give you real specific ideas because each product service is different, but that's that first stage. Now, before we get into the second point I want to make, I believe that passive knowledge, instruction, or training is limited. The best way for what I am trying to share with you to have the greatest, deepest, and most valuable impact is for you right now to stop. And if you're in tables, go around your table and take a moment and discuss with everybody at that table the one thing that you specifically grasped, got, and realize from listening to this part of my discussion that will have a meaningful impact and maybe a shift in how you do your selling or your marketing or your lead generation and sales funnel process. Because if there are 800 or 8,000 of you in the room listening to me or listening to Dr. Cialdini, You are all hearing this from a different point of view. You all have different experiences, you have different definitions, you have different thoughts that are coming up. If you alone are left to live with what you get from what I say, you are limiting your benefit. If you listen to what 10 or 12 other people perceived, got, understood, and are going to do with the same information you heard, most of them are going to, they have understood it differently, they're going to apply it differently. If you understand 12 different ways to use it, you've just expanded your ability and your success probability many times. So take 5 or 10 minutes, whatever the people at Learning Edge are going to allow you, and discuss it around your table before I continue. I'll wait.